In this video, I'll be demonstrating how to take your hard drive from the base terminal and insert it into the back of the monitor to prepare it for a wall mount. The first thing you're going to want to do is make sure the power is off to the terminal. Disconnect the power cable. Just pulls out. Then you're going to remove the plastic cover from the front and remove the screw next to the hard drive tray. Once the screw is removed, you're going to need to lower the metal bar, snap that out, slide the tray out, and you're going to need to remove the four screws on the back of the hard drive tray. Once you have your hard drive out, set that to the side for a moment. And you're going to need to remove the monitor from the base station. To do that, you need to push the plastic clip in the back, keep it held there, and from the front bottom of the monitor, lift up and it'll slide right out. You're then going to need to disconnect your hard drive power and the SATA cable. Once those are removed, on the top right-hand corner of the monitor, there are two screws. We're going to remove those screws and the plate will lift off. And this is where you'll be inserting the hard drive without the tray. You lift this piece up and inside you'll notice that there's two cables. Solid cable has a little L shape in the port. And the other cable is the data cable for the hard drive. There's only two spots that they can fit on the hard drive. When you're inserting these, the power cable has a little L, so the L is going to match up with the other one. On the data cable, you'll look inside the cable and notice that there's metal flats on the top. Those are going to match up with the flats on the bottom of the hard drive. So you just line those up, slide them in, line up the L, once those are attached, you're going to slide the hard drive back into the drop down area. It's just going to sit there. There's backstops behind the RAM, and it's just going to sit in there nicely. When you reattach the plate, it's going to hold everything in place. So just slide that back on and reattach the screws. Once the screws are in, you're ready to attach it to your wall mount. The wall mount is going to look like this, and on the flat side is where the monitor is going to attach. The four metal brackets on the back of the monitor, two here, are going to go to the corresponding holes on the mounting bracket. So attach your mounting bracket to the wall. You're given two sheets of paper with instructions on them, one with measurements that you could use a tape measure and mark the wall yourself, or you could use this template and just put it up against the wall, cut out a little hole, mark the area where you want to drill. It gives you the drill bit size on the paper. This one happens to be a quarter inch drill. And also with the assembly comes four screws and anchors. You're gonna put your anchors in first after you drill, and then screw your plate to the wall through the four main holes that the brackets mount into. Once the plate's attached to the wall, you can then attach the four brackets into the plate, and you will have your two touch mounted on the wall. After it's mounted on the wall, you need to go back through and reconnect your cables. You'll need to replace your power, the DC in. You'll need to replace the SATA, plug that back in, and the HDD power. Once that's done, you'll be able to turn it on and run two touch.